This video will give you a preview of our free Learn On Demand series for deep learning and neural networks. Stay tuned because at the end of the video, I'll give you a clickable link where you can register and take this Learning On Demand curriculum.
The goal of an artificial neural network is to arrive at a conclusion with the least amount of error as quickly as possible. This video covers the complete training process flow of a deep feed-forward network, describes the key functions of an ANN, and explains how they work together to optimize a machine learning model. A neural network has three key functions. These functions are scoring input, calculating error and loss, and adjusting the parameters of the entire network to reduce error. In this image, you see a depiction of a neural net showing an input layer on the left, the output on the right, and multiple hidden layers in between. Each layer is made up of a collection of artificial neurons, also called nodes. Neural networks are loosely patterned on the behavior of neurons in the human brain, which fires or activates when it encounters sufficient stimuli. A node layer is a column of these neuron-like switches, which turn on or off as input is fed through the net. In a deep learning network, each layer of nodes trains on a distinct set of input features based on the preceding layer's output. Training first walks through the entire network in a full forward-pass sweep that starts at the input layer on the left and works its way through each hidden layer until it reaches an output. Let's start at the first hidden layer to see what is going on in each artificial neuron. This is where computation happens, and it is the activity taking place here that determines if a neuron will meaningfully activate or not. First, the node combines input data with a set of weights, or coefficients, which either dampens or amplifies the input. This associates significance to each input for the task that the algorithm is learning. Weights essentially map each input to a guess of how significant the node is in relation to its expected output prediction. Each node may then apply a bias in an effort to have closer alignment with the training dataset, by balancing out acceptable thresholds before scores are sent to the activation function. The addition of bias increases the flexibility of a model and speeds up training time. So, on a per-node basis, an input weight and bias computation get summed to create a total input score. The resulting sum is then passed through an activation function, which is what determines the significance of each neuron as it passes through the rest of the network. The activation function essentially asks, how important is this input to determining the final predicted output? If a required threshold has not been met, the node does not fire. It passes a zero value through the rest of the network, signifying its low importance to the predicted output. If the required threshold has been met, the activation function allows the signal of that node to progress further through the network of additional layers. This is the process that each node goes through during the forward pass through a neural network. Remember, each layer trains on a distinct set of features, which are based on the output of the previous layer. The further you advance into the neural net, the greater the complexity of the features that the nodes begin to recognize. This is because they are aggregating and recombining features from the previous layer. When this process completes through all the nodes of all layers, it reaches the end of the forward pass through the neural net. A predicted output is reached, and the final key functions come into play. At the onset of model training, actual output is included along with training input. The predicted output is compared to its actual output, and loss is calculated. This takes into consideration both the direction and magnitude of error. The loss calculation is then used to adjust the parameters of the model to reduce the contribution of error of each neuron. An artificial neuron rewards weighted inputs that support its correct guesses and adjusts mistakes where weighted inputs lead to error. The network now walks back through the model, encountering all error nodes that did not fire, and iteratively adjusts parameters as necessary to each node in each layer as it does a backward pass through the entire network. The goal of this process is to optimize the model and reduce the amount of error during the next pass. These forward and backward passes through a network creates a dynamic feedback loop and is how the model learns. Machine learning occurs in a series of training cycles, or epochs, So this process repeats, hopefully until the error can't be reduced any further. The next lesson takes a deep dive look at this process, using a concrete image classification example, complete with calculations to show how these basic computations come together to predict and improve output during model training.
Here's the clickable link where you can sign up for this free HPE Learn on Demand course. And if you want to explore the other curriculum that's available, once you get to the page, just click on the text on the top left that says HPE Learn on Demand.